Hello people, this is Sonali, the Melodramatic Bookworm. If you've been here before, welcome back. And if you're new to my channel, welcome to the Melodramatic Bookworm family. I'm here today with the mid-year book freakout tag. I do this tag every single year and I have so much fun doing it. It's like a mid-year check-in where we talk about books that we've loved, books that we've not loved, books we've DNF'd, or a whole lot of them. I will leave the link to the original creator's channel as well as the video in the description box below. I started booktubing in 2018 and I have done this tag every single year, 2018, 19, 20. If you'd like to go check those three videos out, the links will be in the description box below. And I have super fun. There are like 16 questions which I have so much fun answering, because they almost cover the entire reading experience, I feel like. And I am super pumped to do it this time as well. I know I'm a little bit late because I am on a booktube break right now, but I cannot miss doing this video. I cannot miss doing this tag, because first, it's a tradition, and second, it's a tag because I have so much fun answering questions, and that's how I feel like my whole reading honesty comes out. Otherwise, my memory is a fish. I forget almost everything. So without any further ado, let's dive right into this video and into this tag, and let me share with you my answers to the questions of the mid-year book freakout tag. A quick reminder, if you'd like to buy any of the books mentioned in this video, then please use my Amazon affiliate links in the description box below. It would be of immense help to me. Question number one, the best book you've read so far this year. Okay, there are way too many books that I can't not include in this because they are so good. So I'm not going to keep pulling out books off my shelf. I'll just leave the covers over here. The first one is Long Way Down by Jason Reynolds. I think I've spoken about this in one of my previous videos. I will link that if you like. And then there is Boys Will Be Boys by Clementine Ford. She is a great feminist activist, author, social media person, I'd say. And Boys Will Be Boys also talks about not only how patriarchy affects women, but also how it affects men, like toxic masculinity. And then The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo by Taylor Jenkins Reid. It is amazing. Like, I cannot even begin to explain how amazing it is. There's so much. I've spoken about this in a subscriber pick video. If you'd like to go check that video out, I'll leave the link here as well as in the description box below. But it's amazing. It's so great. And then the Brown Sister series by Talia Hibbert, which is another great adult romance. And then, of course, how can I forget this, The Ember Quartet by Sawa Tahir. You've seen me cry, you've seen me bawl over those books. And then Six of Crows duology by Leigh Bardugo. That's another duology, another sub-series that I had a ball reading as well as I cried too. Oh, and a very recent book, I don't know if you will have seen my June wrap-up by this point, but The Anthropocene Reviewed by John Green is great. It's a non-fiction book by John Green, a full 5 stars for me. And it was something different. Like, John Green was reviewing humanity and the human age of the Anthropocene, which we are in right now. And it's great. It's great how we can go from one point to the other and not even make you blink. Whereabouts by Jhumpa Lahiri, which is a great book, especially for people who love being alone. The level of relatability is off the charts. And then Funny Boy by Shyam Selvadurai. The Underground Railroad by Colson Whitehead, another heart-wrenching book about slavery. And then the Heartstopper series by Alice Oseman. This series is great. I mean, I read it on Webtoons and I am now in love with Nick and Charlie. They are so sweet. Question number two, the best sequel you've read this year. I wonder what it is. A Sky Beyond the Storm by Sabaa Tahir, which is the fourth in the Ember Quartet. It rounds off the whole thing, and I cried like a baby. And I feel like the author rounded off everything so well. For me, it was like something else. And then Crooked Kingdom by Leigh Bardugo. This is the second in the Sticks of Crows duology, and that was also something. That chapter number 40 is like, why? Why would you do that to us? But those six crows are, they have my whole heart. I would do anything for them, it feels like. Question number 3. A new release that you haven't read yet but really want to read. A new release, a book that released during this year. And there are quite a few. One is, wait, it's here only, so I can. Concrete Rose by Angie Thomas. And I don't know why. I don't know why I haven't picked this up yet. Because I love her book so much. And then Firekeeper's Daughter by Angeline Boley. I also have the audiobook, Libro FM audiobook, but I haven't been able to get started. I mean, I had to go and buy the paperback because the cover is so phenomenal. So I went and bought it, and I really want to read this before the year ends. And then there's also Rule of Wolves by Leigh Bardugo. This is the second in the King of Scars duology, and I will be reading it this month anyway. But I still haven't finished with King of Scars, so I will get to this once I finish that. That's what I'm trying to say. Huh? What? And then The Four Winds by Kristen Hannah. I absolutely love The Nightingale, and I don't know why I haven't picked this up, even though I think I added it to two of my DVRs, but I didn't pick this up. But I am hearing that this is amazing. This is one of Kristen Hannah's best works and all of that, and I'm like, why am I not picking this up? And then there's also Troy by Stephen Fry. This is a book that we are reading as part of the Drama Queenathon book club, and we will be reading and discussing this in the second week of August. I mean, we could start right away, but I also have an ALC for this, so I'm super, super excited to listen to Stephen Fry tell the story while I read the paperback. It's like, it's going to be awesome. And by the way, this was a gift from a very dear friend. I love you. Question number 4. Your most anticipated release for the second half of the year. And I have two books. One is The Comfort Book, which released on 20th, and it could be here anytime. Because we pre-ordered the book. It was a gift from my husband, a birthday gift. But the next one is Under the Whispering Door by TJ Klune. I really have no clue about what this is about, but since it's TJ Klune, it automatically goes onto the list. Question number 5. Your biggest disappointment. I have quite a few. First is Shaggy Bane by Douglas Stewart. Oh my god. That was such a... It was a bore to read. Second is The White Tiger by Arvind Ariga, and I did not think that it would come onto this list. And the whole book is sort of very disconnected, it felt like to me. Oh, and then, how can I forget this? This should be on at the very top. But the book is Star Daughter by Shweta Thakrar, and it is one of my most AO books I have ever read in my life, because it's badly written. And then Before She Sleeps by Beena Shah, another Handmaid's Tale wannabe. I don't want to talk more about it. And then a DNF, which was The Mistress of Spices by Chitra Banerjee Devakarani. I was not expecting that, but the writing just didn't. It was a no-no for me. Question number 6. Your biggest surprise. And that has got to be the Brown Sister series by Talia Hibbert. I'd been hearing about this series for such a long time. Everybody was like, oh, Get a Life, Chloe Brown is amazing. I was like, okay, what is this? What is the deal with this book? And then I went and read the series, and I know what the deal is with that book, because Get a Life, Chloe Brown is now one of my favorite relatable books ever, and it's amazing. Question number 7. Your favorite new author, or an author that is new to you? Sabha Tahir, Leigh Bardugo. And Leigh Bardugo, actually, I'd already read the Shadow and Bone trilogy last year, but she wasn't my favorite then. But now that I've read Six of Crows and Crooked Kingdom, I'm like, oh, she writes so well. And then Colson Whitehead, Talia Hibbert, Nikesh Shukla. Nikesh Shukla's Brown Baby is great. Question number 8. Your newest fictional crush. Okay. First is Harper from the Ember Quartet. Oh, he's so good. And then, okay, Kaz and Jesper from Six of Crows. I'm going to, you know, imagine and tell myself and I'm going to imagine them as not being teenagers, okay? They are 35-year-old men in my head. Okay, I didn't tell you where they were from, although I know that you know. Jesper and Kaz are from the Six of Crows duology. And then there is Redford Morgan from Get a Life, Chloe Brown. Oh my god, he is the absolute sweetest. And he is tall, he is good looking, and he is sweet, and he paints, and what the heck? How can I not have a crush on him? Question number 9. Your newest favorite character. The first and foremost are the crows. They have my whole heart. I mean, every single one of them is so quirky, so well written, and they just know you. They understand you. And I'm here like, can I join the crow club? Can I become one of the crows? Please. I think you have a vacancy. That was not fair. And then, of course, Evelyn Hugo from The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. She is iconic and I love her. She's great. Last but not the least, Chloe Brown and Redford Morgan from Get a Life, Chloe Brown. Chloe is sassy. She's relatable to me in, oh my god, there's so many ways. I would love to dissect it in a spoilery way, but let's not get till there. And Redford Morgan, I've already spoken about. Question number 10, a book that made you cry. And I feel like everybody knows the answer to this, okay? The first and foremost one was The Ember Quartet by Sabah Tahir, because we started off the, the year with a lot of tears while reading this series. And then there is Tuesdays with Maury by Mitch Albom, which I read in June and which you've seen the video for. Cricket Kingdom by Leigh Bardugo. Oh my god, no, how? And there's Funny Boy by Shyam Selvadurai. It's like very gut-wrenching, as I've already mentioned. And Where Hope Comes From by Nikita Gill. It's such a beautiful poetry collection that it just warms my heart to know that Nikita Gill, sitting like thousands of miles away, she knows my mind and she knows what I need and she knows what I am at any point in time going through, and she just drops that book on my head like, here, read it, it'll make you feel better. There's one last book which that made me cry. Can you guess what it is? It was Star Daughter, because I cried in frustration. It was that bad. Question number 11, a book that made you happy. There were two sets of books, I would say. The first set is The Six of Crows duology by Leigh Bardugo, and she makes these criminals, these six outcasts, feel like family. She makes them feel like friends, and I'm like, if anything happens to these characters, I'm going to riot. And then the Heartstopper series by Alice Oseman. It's warm, it's happy, it makes you feel happy, it's just so understanding, it's comforting. And Nick and Charlie are two of the most precious boys in the whole world. They need to be protected at all costs. Question number 12. Your favorite book to film adaptation. Not book to film adaptation, but a book to probably show, TV show or series adaptation. And that is Shadow and Bone, because I think that they did a fantabulous job into adapting there's a Shadow and Bone, the first Shadow and Bone book, I think, and to bring in the crows as well from the Six of Crows duology, and using that as a prequel, it felt very amazing to see. Question number 13, your favorite video you've made this year. Okay, it's not something that I've made, but it was a live discussion, and that is the Percy Jackson discussion that we did in June on my channel, and I love that to no end. And then there's also my reading vlogs. I do enjoy making reading vlogs, although they are a lot of work than normal videos. I do enjoy those as well, and I think that I've gotten better at making and doing reading vlogs. And then the bookworm problem sketch, which I am really mortified by even now to watch, because I can't act. I don't have an acting bone in my body, but I felt like it came out better than I was intending it to be, so that's an improvement. And then the book recommendations videos that I've been doing, I enjoyed making those as well, and I intend to do more once I come back from my BookTube break. So don't worry, if you ask me for any recommendations, they will come, only it will take some time. Question number 14. The most beautiful book you've either bought or received this year. Oof, okay. I think it has to be Troy by Stephen Fry. This was sent to me as a birthday gift by a very dear friend. Look at this. This is great. I was actually going to say Rule of Wolves or Where Hope Comes From. This book. This is also amazing. I bought this book. This was a gift. And yeah, also Kunti. But then again, they are not like books that I would go wow about. But these two books, sure, I can fawn over them for ages. Are you seeing a theme here? Black. Hello, darkness, my old friend. And the last question is, what are some books that you need to read before the end of the year? And I am going to consult this list that I've made in my phone, because I can't tell them off memory. But the remaining books in the 21 books I want to read in 2021 list, okay, which are War and Peace by Leo Tolstoy, which I don't know if I will be able to, it's a huge chunker. And we started it earlier in the year, but I abandoned it. And Shantaram by Gregory David Roberts, The Adivasi Will Not Dance by Hansdas Sauvindra Shekhar, Man's Search for Meaning by Victor E. Frankl, Bird by Bird by Anne Lamott, If on a Winter's Night a Traveler by Italo Calvino, is his name pronounced? I'm really not sure about it. A Little Life by Hanya Yanagihara. I hope I pronounced her name right. Oh my god, please let me be right. Such a Fun Age by Kylie Reid. Drive Your Plow Over the Bones of the Dead by Olga Tokarczuk. Against the Loveless World by Susan Abulhawa. Stories of Your Life and Others by Ted Chiang. And these are the books that are on my 21 books I want to read in 2021 list. But there are others among my TBR that I really want to get to as well. Firekeeper's Daughter by Angeline Boley, King of Scars and Rule of Wolves by Leigh Bardugo, and then Daughters of the Sun by Ira Mukhoti, Atomic Habits, which I will be reviewing for my members, and Make Time by Jake Knapp and John Zeratsky. And I had to have read this earlier this year, but I couldn't. Homegoing and Transcendent Kingdom by Yagyasi, I think it's how it's pronounced. The Winter Night Trilogy by Catherine Arden. A Gentleman in Moscow by Amor Towles. Villains Never Die by, who was it? Nick Wolfe, I think his name is. Then Before the Coffee Gets Cold. And basically, there are a lot of books that I really want to read by the end of the year. But we know that realistically that isn't possible. So let's just hope I get through as many as I can. So that was my mid-year book freakout tag of 2021. Did I freak out enough? And if I didn't, then I think that's a good sign that things are going well for me. But although I don't think things are going... Anyway, let's not go there. That's a lot to unpack over there. But so what did you think of this video? Did you like any of the books that I mentioned in here? Or have you read any of them? Which ones do I need to prioritize from the list of 100 books that you've seen me talk about? And what are your answers to these questions. What is your favorite book of 2021? What's your worst book of 2021? And would you be buying anything from this list that I've spoken about in these however many minutes? If you are planning to buy any of the books mentioned in this video, then please use my Amazon affiliate links in the description box below. It would be of immense help to me. And do let me know what you think in the comments below. I would love to hear from you. If you like this video, please like it and share it to spread the word. And if you like my content and would like to see more from me, don't forget to hit subscribe and click on the bell icon beside the subscribe button to get notified as and when I post new videos. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Until next time, keep reading, keep watching, and add melodrama to your life.